Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom, and today's video will show you a quick, easy, and free way to grab a screenshot, that is, a picture of your computer screen, to save, email, or print. We'll walk through the steps together, and you'll find a one-page recap at the end of the video for convenience. Most people use screenshots to capture something on their computer screen that they want to save or share with others. For example, you might have a scary message on your screen that you're not sure what to do about. Your tech support can be a lot more helpful if you can send them a picture of what you are seeing. Some people try to do this with a smartphone camera, but then you have to deal with focus and glare. The better way is to use the Snipping Tool, which is a great little feature that's built into every version of Windows. You don't need to buy anything. If you have a Windows computer, you already have this tool. The easiest way to open the Snipping Tool is from the keyboard, using a combination of three keys that are found on every Windows keyboard, whether it's a compact laptop keyboard or a full-size desktop keyboard. You'll need the Windows key, which looks like this or sometimes like this, and you'll need the Shift key and the letter S. Some keyboards have two Windows keys and two Shift keys, by the way. They're interchangeable. Use whichever ones are most comfortable for you. To open the Snipping Tool, all you do is hold down the Windows key and the Shift key at the same time, and then tap the letter S. S for snip, of course. Now let's see how this works on the computer. Here's a screen we want to capture. We hold down the Windows key and the Shift key and tap the letter S. You'll see the screen dim slightly and a little toolbar pops up at the top of the screen. Once you see that, you can release the keys if you haven't already. Here's a bigger view of the toolbar so you can see it better. On the right-hand end, the X will close the Snipping Tool. That should be pretty obvious. The other four icons let you choose what part of the screen you're going to capture. The full screen, a particular window, a rectangular area, or a freeform area. The easiest and most common choice is full screen next to the X, so let's start with that. Click the full screen icon. The toolbar disappears and a window pops up letting you know that the snip you just took has been copied to the clipboard. Click anywhere on that little window and the Snipping Tool opens in a new window and shows you the image you just captured. Let's close the window behind it so it's less confusing and zoom in a bit. The next step is to decide what to do with your screenshot. There are a bunch of tools in the top center here that let you mark up the image, crop, and rotate if you want to. You can experiment with those, but for brevity's sake, we're not going to cover them here. Let's focus on the essential icons over on the right. If you're trying to email this image to someone, you'd logically click on the Share button right here. Unfortunately, Share is pretty limited. It works best with the Windows Mail app. If you don't use Windows Mail, though, you can still send it as an attachment in any kind of email. We just need to save it first. To save the captured image, click the Save As button right here. If you're old enough to remember them, it looks like a floppy disk. The Save As window appears, and all you have to do is select a location and a name for the file. I usually use the desktop as the location so the file's easy to find. The name is already filled in for you, screenshot plus the date and a time code. You can change it if you want, otherwise just click Save, and here is your screenshot saved on the desktop. Once you have it saved, write an email however you normally do, click the Attach button, typically a paperclip, navigate to the desktop or wherever you saved it, and select the screenshot. Easy peasy. Most of the time, that's all you need to know, so you can skip ahead to the recap if you want, or stick with me for a quick look at some other useful options in the Snipping Tool. Once again, hold the Windows and Shift keys and tap S to bring up the Snipping Tool. This time, instead of grabbing the whole screen, let's choose the Window option. Unlike last time, we don't immediately get the pop-up Snipping Tool window. Instead, it's waiting for us to choose which window we want to capture because there are a couple different ones open right now. If I point to the calculator, you'll see that it becomes brighter. Click on the window you want to capture, and now we get the pop-up. Click on the pop-up window again to open the Snipping Tool and see what you have captured. Suppose we wanted to print this image. There's no print icon, but there's a More menu, which is the three dots right here. Click the three dots, and on this menu, as you can see in the blow-up, you find Print. Last but not least, suppose you just want to capture a specific part of the screen, not the full screen, not an entire window. Once again, hold Windows and Shift and tap the letter S. That's what these two buttons are for. Let's click Rectangular mode. your mouse pointer becomes a plus sign. Move that pointer to one corner of the area you want to capture, and now click and drag diagonally to select a rectangular area. When you release the mouse button, you get the snipping tool prompt and once again click on it to access the options for saving, sharing, or printing. The freeform button works exactly the same way, except that you can capture a blob of any shape you can draw with your mouse rather than a rectangle. So it's all pretty easy, just as long as you can remember that it starts with Windows Shift S, S for snip. As with many Windows features, there are a bunch of other ways to get to the snipping tool, including searching for it in your apps. But the keyboard shortcut is my favorite because it's fast, easy, and works on every Windows computer. So it's worth taking the time to memorize that key combination. As promised, here's a quick recap of the steps. To take a screenshot, hold the Windows key and the Shift key at the same time and tap the letter S. When you see the toolbar, you can release the keys. Then choose one of the four options: full screen, window, and then click on the window you want, rectangular or freeform, click and drag to select an area. Then click on the prompt window to open the screenshot in Snipping Tool. Then, as desired, use the share button if you use Windows Mail, save as to keep your screenshot as a file, which you can attach to any kind of email, or print by clicking on the three dots menu and choosing print. You might try taking a screenshot of this screen and saving or emailing it or printing it for practice. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.